What's up, YouTube world? It's your boy Monkey, and I have another Ultimate Gamer for you guys. Ultimate Gamer number 6 on Carrier. Now, Carrier is a medium-sized open map, which everyone knows that follows me on this YouTube thing. They know I love these maps. This is one of my favorite maps there is. I call it Score Streak Heaven. So without further ado, let's start the show. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Carrier. From a plan view, top view, looking down on it. And right here, these are the callouts for the map that I created for you guys. This is here just to help you guys out, just so you're kind of familiarize yourself with the map. Tell your teammates, oh, I got shot by Hilo. Okay, so I know, I'll turn around and that's where I got killed. And so it helps your teammates out tremendously if you know these callouts. Now, this last bit of information that you're about to get right now, this is the heat map. Now, red being the most concentrated area of deaths, to dark green, to lighter green, so on and so forth. The darker the color, the more the death. So, all right, ladies and gentlemen, here's the video. So today we start off on the Chinese side. And I'm using that M27 assault rifle, which one of my subscribers told me to kind of use. Check it out. And because of him, I fell in love with this gun, no homo. And I really, really, really am enjoying this gun. It's very powerful. From the long distance, it has the worst damage rate, but it makes up for the fire rate. So for me, it's kind of like, and it's actually like the, I'm comparing it to the ACR when it comes to stability and muzzle lift. It has very little muzzle lift. So it's like a laser beam. As you see right here, it's a little bit of lag trying to catch those guys. But normally in engagements, when there's no lag, this gun is really a beast. It tears people up to shreds. I haven't really been talking about guns on these on my Ultimate Gamer series, and I don't know if it's something that you guys would like to hear about. It's just something that I think it's very used up. It's a saturated market when it comes to that. That's why I kind of don't do it. There's so many people out there that are doing research and studies with these guns, shooting walls up and doing statistics. And it's just not me. I kind of, when I want to check out a gun, I'll go into combat training and just use different setups and just feel out the guns before I actually take them out to multiplayer. I personally find using combat training a very, very helpful tool in the Black Ops series. And I wish that they had that in Modern Warfare 3. Just to get used to score streaks. Just to get used to, like I said, the guns, the different options that you have to attach, the attachments that go on these guns. I mean, everything is totally different, and it changes the gun's balance, it changes the gun's shooting abilities, it changes the way you move. There's just so many variables that by simply adjusting the attachment on the weapon itself can turn one gun into multiple types of guns. Like, I mean, putting a stock on this, like I was saying before, changes the behavior of the weapon so you can move side to side, so you can strafe left and right faster than normal. Adding a silencer like I have on this reduces the recoil of the weapon. So, like I said, you guys have to go in. The best thing to do is go into combat training, test these things out on these, test out the attachments on these weapons, and just suit it, match it to your playstyle. So, I mean, like I said, this game is very, like, it's, I want to say it's one-dimensional, as in what you can do in this, as in running and gunning. But if you really sit down and think about what they've given us, what Treyarch has given us, and the abilities of what you can do now with these weapons and perks, it's endless. It's just too bad that SMGs are really king in this, because there are some, majority of the assault rifles really do blow. But the three that I really like are the FAL, the SCAR, and now this M27. These guns, you could do wonders with them. All right, let's make a transition from weapons to the actual map here, Carrier. Now, the spawns on this map, there are four predominant spawns, four quadrants of the map that people, when you die, you come back to life. And what you're about to see on the screen depicts what I'm talking about. So, watch this. Now, the spawns on this map, it's very simple, actually. There are four spots that I see. If you guys see something else that I don't see, please put it in the comments. But the four that I've really noticed on this, starting with Hilo, then C-Dom, then Stealth Bomber, and then A-Dom. Those four spots on this map, and they're nice and open too, so when you have kill streaks or score streaks that you're flying in or that you're actually controlling, you get the pinpoint and just keep on firing, and those are the four spots that you keep checking. So it like I said, I love this type of map for aerial score streaks. Perfect. So if you're a good enough player on this game and can attain those higher score streaks, I would highly advise the Lodestar, the VTOL Warship, and definitely, most definitely, the Swarm. I didn't have the Swarm on this one because I just got thrown into the game itself, but I wish that Treyarch took the format of Modern Warfare 3's per class kill streak score streak system. That worked the best, because if there's something going on and I can't, you know, attain my higher score streaks, I could always switch to a class that has my lower score streaks. So it's a little bit more, I could balance out the game itself, but they didn't implement that in this version of Call of Duty. So what are we going to do? I'm not going to cry about it. All right, guys, let's get back to the game. So I'm running through Command Bridge towards the Stealth Bomber side. And I'm just running around the perimeter. Like you guys know, if you follow me on this, like I've been saying this for eons, I run perimeter. Once in a blue moon, I'll kind of go towards the middle if I'm cutting in and out of obstacles. I mean, look how fast this gun kills. So I'm trying to make my way down here by A-Dom and back. And, oh, what a surprise. Guy camping out on the stairs, which is crazy. I like using the stairs right here, those stairs right there, as a head glitching spot towards Overwatch. Past fire truck, because I know a lot of snipers love to hang out there. Now, I just overheard that there's an enemy hunter killer drone in the air. I don't have blind eyes, so I just run to cover. I don't want to lose my score streak right now. I'm kind of close to an orbital, and I'm not trying to die. I'm constantly looking at the mini-map when there's a UAV up, even when there's not a UAV up, because I know right here that right now I'm just trying to let that hunter killer drone pass me by. And I'm looking back here towards A to see if that's going to be the spawn, the enemy spawn, as you see me running back and forth here. And that's the way I play. I constantly look mini-map. I look to see where my guy, see skulls right there? Okay, so I know that there are only two options. A, that there's a spawn there, or B, that there's just a bunch of people there that just showed up that are following in tandems or triples. It's situational and map awareness. So I acquire my orbital VSAT, which is one of my favorite score streaks on this. It just helps out your team, and it helps me with bonuses, and I could see them. I could see the positioning of the soldiers. Like, this guy was facing towards the water, so I knew that I could just ADS and kill him with minimal resistance. As this is all going down, I know that the spawn is it's by C-Dom. So I'm like, oh man, am I gonna get overwhelmed? So I'm just running, trying to get my score streaks. Got everything. So from here on out, I can give two shits what happens. But I know where the positions are, and I don't know how I die right there. That's a questionable death. I started firing first. It's okay. I'll just let my dogs take care of my garbage. So now I'm just saving my VTOL warship. I'm letting my dogs do the killing, letting them flush out the enemy team out of their camp spots if they do decide to camp, because Monkey Airlines is now about to do some damage. So now I'm checking to see where they are first, right? So you kind of wipe them out off the map. Then you start checking the spawns. This, the VTOL warship is such a badass score streak. I can't even explain to you. Look at this. Missiles. I have basically the chopper gunner just sewing them, mowing them down. This guy shoots me with a missile. Nah, that's not going to happen. It's not going to take me down. Like I was telling you guys with the spawns on this, it's fairly easy to remember, and it's kind of easy to see with this because it highlights the enemies for you. And now you add the element of mental retardation to the equation, it's just like shooting crabs in the bucket. I'm just checking spawns, every single quadrant. Alright, A-Dom, nothing, cool. Alright, C-Dom, perfect. And then they finally take me out. So I had a nice little run, I can't complain about that. So I wake up right here from my score streak to their spawn. So I just don't know where they're coming from. Slice this guy. See, this guy can't kill him. And he gets blown out of his boots by the Hellstorm missile. Another situational awareness technique that I've been using, since you can't really sound horn this game per se, is I listen to what team I'm on. Since I'm on the Chinese team, I listen for the American voices so I know where they're coming from. So if I hear, you know, a Chinese guy scream, I know that that's my team. But if I hear an American, I know that that's the opposing team. So that's just another little technique that I've been using in this game. I notice right here that my teammate gets killed. Post up, kill this guy, take his tag, and I'm back on the hunt. I notice at the tag count right now, when we're at 97, and I know that nothing else is gonna happen. If anything, I'll get an orbital, if I get that. I know that they're spawning around this area right here, and what happens? I get the final kill to close out the session. Guys, thank you so much for watching this. This was Ultimate Gamer number 6 on Carrier for Black Ops 2. This is your boy Monkey. I'm signing out. Till next time. Peace.